some of the.
Alright, so we can tell this is gonna be a line. It looks like y equals mx plus b. That's our rate of change. And there'll be rainbows per hour. Five rainbows every 8 hours. Or any number of different rates, okay, of something per something else. We know it's going to be aligned with the graphic, so the easiest thing we could do is find two points. The easiest point we could find first would be what?
Negative 3.
By plugging in what for x?
0.
All right, 0, negative 3, you plug in 0. There's 0 minus 3. 0, negative 3. Okay? And we can go over, you can plug in 1 or 2 or 3 or 4, but then we're going to have a fraction involved there. So, what number could we plug in that would make this calculation easy, Jen?
8.
Number 8 would be great. 8 is great because when we plug in 8, 8 divides 8 and we get 1. So we get 5 times 1 divided by 1, or 5 divided by 1 times 1, whatever, however we look at it, we have 5 here. And 5 minus 3 is 2. So 8, 2, 8, 2. And if this was, rainbows per hour, 5 rainbows per 8 hours, every 8 hours that go by, Clabber earns 5 rainbows, and he's in the positive rainbow now. If 8 more hours go by, 5 more, 8 hours, so then you see the rate of change of the slope of the line, Jen.
0.
What's that?
The 0 word?
0 for what? We did that, we put in 0 for x, and negative 3, that was natural. I'm sure it was.
Okay. 16? That would make a bigger one. We could always do negative 8.
Right. And really, when you plug in negative 8, you plug in 16, or you plug in 24, 32.
We're finding more points than we really need to
find. We can find 2 points to graph this line. We found 2 of them. So I plug in 0 first, then plugging in 8. It's not the denominator 8. And now there are more fractions left. Okay. So that will just been a very quick little bit of review if there weren't so much interruption. Maybe the remainder of the class can be relatively interruption-free, right? And we'll have a bunch of time to do some homework. Otherwise, this entire hour and a half would be me talking to you, doing exercise problems, not because I'm trying to punish you, but because you are making it impossible for us to move on. So let's not do that. Let's continue to move on at a good pace by stopping interrupting me. Right? Not really me, but the whole class. So that's a bit of review. How was that review? Did it make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, today, we're talking about graph lines in slope-intercept form. That was kind of a review. There we go. Right. Done this quite a bit, right? You should have that pretty well under wraps. We're going to graphs of lines in standard form, they're going to write equations of lines in 3 different scenarios where I give you 2 points, a point and a slope, or a slope and a y-intercept. All right, so let's look at, I guess we can do one more example. One more example of graphing the slope-intercept form. Just take one. Yes.
It'll be 0 and 6.
So 0, 6, we plug in 0. 0 times negative 3 fourths is 0, plus 6 is 6.
Yes.
So there's a point at 0, 6. All right, we need a second point.
4.
What do you mean by 4, Jason?
Make x 4.
Make x 4. Well, if we move over 4, we can see we're going to lose 3 in the y direction. If we do the math here,
yes.
If we do it the super long way, negative 3 times 4 is negative 12. Over 4 times 1 is 4. Multiply straight across in those fractions. Negative 12 divided by 4 is negative 3. 6, negative 3 plus 6 is 3. Which would be the same as if we moved over 4 and what? 4 and down 3, right? Which puts us right at 4, comma 3. Hold on, line down here. Plug in 0, then plug in the number that you see in the denominator. Great, you found 2 points. And you're using the function as a function is meant to be used, plugging something in, getting something out. So you can see quickly that there is always going to be a point at 0, this guy here, right? For any equation like this, there's always going to be a point at 0, whatever b is. Because this would go away and we just have b left. Then we can follow the slope from there. Right that much and up that much. Okay? If one of those numbers is negative, then instead of right, we move left, instead of up, we move down. If both negative, we move to the left and down. Here's what we call standard form. Imagine this is a bit of review. Like this, it's easy, very easy to plug in 0 for x. It's no different here. Plug in 0 for x. What happens to this term? 2 times 0 is? 0. So there's nothing there. 0 plus 3y, so that's just 3y.
3 divided by h equals 4.
Divide by 3 on both sides?
Yes.
So 0, 4.
0, 4. There's a point. 0, 4.
0 for x is
a thing that you might not have thought of, because this isn't how we typically use functions, but we could plug something in for y as well. What do you want to plug in for y?
6.
6? How about 0? Why not 0? What's easier to multiply by than 0?
0. 1.
Sometimes 0 is easier. The answer is always the same when you multiply by 0, right? Every time it's 0. Even when you multiply by 1, the answer changes. But multiply by 0, 0 times anything is 0. So we're left with 2x equals 12. Divide by 2 on both sides, we get 6. 6 for x, 0 for y. So when it's written this way, as so many times x plus so many times y equals 12, since it's not solved for y like this equation is, faster just to plug in a 0 for x, a 0 for y. You got 2 points. 1 is 0, 4. 1 is 6, 0. Draw yourself a little line. Equals 24. It's a standard form. Try that same approach, the same strategy. Finding 2 points and then graph the lines between those 2 points. Okay, who's got a point? 1 point, Shelby?
I've got 8, 0.
8, 0. Kind of went backwards. I think most people would. So 8, 0, Shelby, or maybe somebody else tell me how Shelby got that point, 8, 0. Jason?
So she plugged 0 in for y.
Good, right? X, always x comma y, so she plugged in 0 up for y, and got 3x equals 24, divided by 3, and, sorry, not y, but x equals 8. It's another point that's pretty simple, up for grabs. Yes? 0, 6. Good. So that means we plug 0 in for x. So 3 times 0 plus 4 times y equals 24. 4y equals 24. Divide by 4 on both sides and y equals 6. So we have 8, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 8 on the x, 0 on the y, 0 on the x, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the y. Draw a point, or sorry, a line between those two points. All good. Now I want to show you another way to go, okay? We can turn this into everybody's favorite form, slope-intercept form. What does slope-intercept form look like, as a reminder? Y equals mx plus b. What would we have to do with this equation to get it to look like y equals mx plus b? Jenna? If we subtract 3x from this side, what's 3x minus 3x?
Nothing.
0x, no x's. And so we'll subtract 3x from this side. Gotta keep it balanced. So just to write it in an order we're familiar with, I'll write it as negative 3x plus 24, same as 24 minus 3x. Okay, we're on our way to mx plus b. So we got rid of that guy there. We're just left with 4y equals negative 3x plus 24. So how do we get y by itself now? Divide what?
Divided by 24.
I just want to get y by itself. I don't really care what's going on here.
Divided by 4.
Divided by 4. What's 4y divided by 4?
Y.
It's just y. 4 divided by 4 is 1, so we have 1y on this side.
Y.
Divided by 4. So here we have y equals now. Since these are added together, we need to divide them both by 4 individually. So we'll have negative 3 fourths x plus 6. Which is the same, makes the same line as we have already. We have a y-intercept at 6. 0 for x, 6 is the answer there. We move over 4 and down 3. That gets us halfway to this other point that we already have. Over 4, down another 3, takes us straight to there. So if we were to solve for y and graph it that way, probably at this point and then that point, but we make the same line. You try. Let me give you negative 6x plus 4y equals 12. Well, this is very similar, but I'm trying to make the numbers work out nicely. And so I want you to rewrite this in slope-intercept form. And if you want to, you can graph it forward, but I just want to exercise our ability to write this in slope-intercept form. Intercept form. All right, so I'm trying to get y by itself, so let's not have this negative 6x. We'll not have a negative 6x. Negative 6x by doing what?
Add to the other side. 6x to the other side.
Well, we should add it to this side too, right?
Yes. Yeah.
And add it to this side.
Yeah.
Negative 6x plus 6x is 0.
Yeah.
Leaves us with 4y equals 6x plus 12. And
then you divide by 4 the whole thing.
Divide by 4 the whole thing. 4y divided by 4 is y. 6 divided by 4 is 3 halves. X plus 12 divided by 4 is 3.
Oh,
3 halves is the same as 1 half.
Oh, okay.
But it's easier to, like, if we're going to think about using this as a slope, it's a lot easier to use it as 3 halves than 1 1/2, because I can just say over 2, about 3, right, 2 about 3.
Yeah.
If it's 1 1/2, then it's harder to use as a slope. If I were to graph this real quick, I know there's a point at 0, 3, because I can plug in 0 real quick for x in my head. I know if I go to the right 2, I'm going to gain 3. So I'll move up 3 from here, go over 2, and there we go, 2 points that belong to my line, and I'll finish out the line like that. That's kind of like a line. standard form, rewriting it in slope intercept form. Okay. Finding the slope of a line that goes through these two points. We could just graph this point at 3, 4, and this point at 8, 12. Just draw this line, right? But if I wanted to find the slope, I just need to know the vertical distance and the horizontal distance. Hold on. So I know this point is at 3, 4, this point is at 8, 12.
Yeah.
Can you figure out how far the vertical change is from here to there just by looking at the graph?
Yeah.
How do we figure it out just from looking at the graph?
Right. Well, the numerator is going to be rise, and the run is going to be the denominator, and it's
going to
be
top of the line. That's rude. So Wyatt, how do we find the vertical change from this point to the other point?
You just count up to get to the sign.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yes.
Go up 8.
Yes.
That's my vertical change, right? That's the delta y, the change in y. What's the change in x from this point to that point? 3, 4, 5. Okay. Vertical change is 8 because from this point to this point we go a positive 8 up 8. And when we continue horizontally, we have to move to the right 5. A positive 8 and positive 5.
Plus or minus? That's the origin.
Well, it only looks like that because I drew a terrible line. Just looking for the slope for the moment. We are going to write an equation, but I just want to write, just want to find the slope to start with. Come back to this, but try yourself. If there is a point, let's say at -2, there's another point on this line, let's say it's at 8, and so we'll call it -8, 3. Let's just start off by looking at the graph and figuring out what the slope is. It could be the slope from here to there, or it could be from here to there, but start at one point, figure out the vertical change, horizontal change, vertical change, horizontal change. Slope. Let's look at the vertical change. Let's say we start from this point, the vertical change over the horizontal change. So if I'm going from this point, vertically then horizontally, how far vertically do I have to go to get down to the vertical level of this point? Rainy? How far do I have to go vertically from this point to this?
Down 5 and over 9.
Oh, wait, you just told us everything. You have to go down 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, right? Two more, it takes us down 5.
Yes.
Down 5, and we have to go over, let's count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more, to get us over this one.
Yeah, I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Can we please stop talking? Alright, so down 5 and over 9. But we don't really have to count this off anytime. We don't have to count it down and over. Let's take this for example. The numbers are all positive, so it kind of is easier to see. So if I start at this point, I want to find the vertical change first. That just means I want to find this distance. Right? Well, that distance is just this distance right? All the way from here to there. Minus this distance. I take this amount and I subtract this amount. This whole distance minus this distance gives me this. So how far is it from here to there? How far is it from here to there? Notice I'm going up to this point. You know where this point is, right? This point is at 8, 12. So yeah, it is 12 above the x-axis. How high is this point here?
4.
4, right? It's right there in the coordinates. 3, 4. So if I take 12 minus 4, it should give me this distance here, right? 12 minus 4. 12 minus 4?
Just stop. 8. You should calculate.
8. 12 minus 4 is 8.
I was whole one.
Now, we've chosen to start here. We're going to go vertically. We're going to have to go up 8. We just figured that out. That's how far it is from there to there. From here to there. Now we're moving horizontally. We want to find that distance. Well, the same kind of deal here. We know how far it is from there to there. How far is it from here to here? Here over to there. It is 8. And how far is it from here to there? From here to there.
5.
From here to there.
3.
That is 3. Right? This point is at 3, 4. We're going horizontally from the y-axis over to this point. So it's 3 here, 8 there. So if I take 8 and subtract 3, that should give me this distance here, 8 minus 3. 8 minus 3, that's 5. There it is. We can count it. We can count up and to the right 5. Or we can find the changes by calculating them, taking this distance 12. That's the y value here. And I call that y2 because it's the second point. We're starting here at point 1, going to point 2. Just took that y value minus this y value. We call that y1. And we took this x value minus this x value. We call it x2, x1. Generally, if we look at two points on a line, we call this point 2, point number 2. Well, that would have the second x and the second y. Here's point number 1. It would have the first x and the first y. The vertical change is just the change from here to there. That would just be y2 minus y1. The horizontal change is just the distance from this point to that point. That would be x2 minus x1. x2 minus x1. So the slope, or the vertical change over the horizontal change, would be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Does that sound familiar? So here we counted off, but we could do the same thing. We just need to, the thing we need to be careful about when we calculate the slope is that particularly like the negative signs that might show up, okay? If there needs to be a negative in there, then there needs to be a negative in there. We don't want to force everything to be positive. Jenny, you going to walk us through it?
Oh, no, I'm just going to ask you. We're going to have a break at
2:30. We're going to have a long old break. We can get through all of this. And the break could start at 45, okay. And then we would just have all the time to work from there to
45.
So, let's say we just pick this point to be point 2, and this to be point number 1. Number 1 and point number 2. This one's going to have x2 and y2. This one's going to have x1 and y1. So, if we follow what we just said, y2 minus y1 would be 3 minus negative 2.
Okay.
X2 minus x1, which is So this would be negative 8, right? X2 minus X1 is 1. Negative 8 minus 1?
Negative
7. Negative 9. Yeah, we have a negative 8. Here's negative 8. Negative 8 minus 1. Which is a negative 9.
See, it's
but when we counted it off, we found negative 5 over positive 9. Here we found 5, positive 5 over negative 9. Does that make a difference?
No, because either way, you're going to get the same slope,
mm-hmm.
and it'll get the same thing if you just flip the y's and the x's this way. But they always have to be in the same consecutive order.
Yeah, same order. So y2 comes first, x2 comes first.
Yeah.
Okay. Always y2 comes first, x2 comes first. It does not matter which point is 2 and which point is 1. It does not matter which point is 2 and which is 1. It'll still work out. If I switch this for 2, this is point 2 and this is point 1, I'll get a negative 5 over a positive 9. Both of those are equal to a negative 5 ninths.
Yeah.
The number 5 ninths, negative 5 ninths. If we look at it this way, this means down 5 in the right 9, down 5 in the right 9. If we look at it this way, we'll just start here and go up 5 in the left 9, up 5 into the left 9. Same thing. Alright, so let's find the slope between these two points. But faster way, we can calculate the slope here. I just need to pick one of these to be 0.1 and one of them to be 0.2. Doesn't matter. So I'll just pick this to be point number 1. This to be point number 2. We have this slope formula, y minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So this is 0.2. That makes this the y value of the 0.2. That makes it y2. So we have y2 minus y1. That's 7. Here's the important part. I want to make sure I come back to point 2 first. 11 minus 5. I don't want to get 5 minus 11. Also, be careful that you don't switch the numerator and denominator. The numerator is the vertical change, and the denominator is the horizontal change. Y is vertical, x is horizontal. So negative 4 minus 7. We're going 7 more into the negative. We're at negative 11. And 11 minus 5, 6. Negative 11, 6. You might have gotten 11 over negative 6. But that's the same thing.
Bring it down anymore?
Bring it down anymore? No, 6 and 11. 11 is prime. It doesn't have any factors.
Well, I mean, like,
oh.
That's a different
math function?
Yeah, it's a weird question.
It's like a mixed number or something?
No, it was like,
okay, I got
it. There's something Parsons.
Figure it out or ask Parsons, let me know. Okay, so negative 11, 6, what's negative 11, 6 about all this situation here? The slope of the line that goes between these two points. So we take it a step further. Okay. So right here. We found the slope. We're going to take these two points. First thing we've done is find the slope. We're going to write the equation of the line. If I were to write this equation, y equals mx plus b, do I know anything about this equation now that I've done all this work? B is the y-intercept. Do you know what the b-intercept or the y-intercept is off the top of your head?
For this?
For this?
We don't. We don't know what the y-intercept is for this graph.
No.
Do we know about this graph? Do we know about this line?
It's M.
The slope. The slope is M. So I know some of this equation so far. I know that in y equals mx plus b, negative 11, 6 is b. Or sorry, not b, but m, the slope. Negative 11, 6, x plus b. This is is almost the equation of the line, I just don't know what b is. So we're gonna figure out what b is, and then there we go. We'll have the equation. Do I know something about this line?
Yes.
So I don't know what b is just off the top of my head. Do you know something about this line given the information we were given?
Yes.
What do we know?
We know that one of the points is 5, 7.
And one of the points is 5, 7. The other point is 11, -4. This is how a function works. I plug in an x and I get out a y, so I could just call this x5 and this y7. I could call this x11 and this y -4. But since 5, 7 are both positive, let's use that. We'll plug in 7 for y, 5 for x, and now all that's left is b. Figure out what b is. So 7 equals -5 over 1. Negative 11 times 5 is -55 over 6 plus b. How do we solve for b? Got -55/6 plus b. We want to just have b by itself.
Don't you subtract the
7
to the negative
55? If I subtracted 7, I think I get 0 over here, and then I'd have a bunch of stuff over here. Would I rather not have this -55/6?
Yep.
How can I cancel out this -55/6?
Plus 55/6.
What's -55/6 plus 55/6?
0.
0, right? We want to add it here because we're essentially subtracting 55/6 from b. So we'll add 55/6 to both sides. B now is equal to 7 plus 55/6. How am I going to add 7 and 55/6? What do we need to find?
7 over how much 55 is, how many wholes is 55 over 6?
We're adding fractions. What do we need to add fractions?
It would just be like 7, 55/6. Okay.
What do we need to add fractions though?
Common denominator.
Common denominator. Very good. So if you find a common denominator, we'll multiply this by 6. That's by 6. We'll get 42 over 6 plus 55 over 6, which is 97 over 6.
Yeah.
And that's b. Y equals -11/6 x plus 97/6, or equals 16 and 1/6. So our y-intercept would be 16 and 1/6, and our slope would be down 11 to the right 6. 11/6. So if we use those two points to find the slope, okay, then plug in the slope and plug in one of the points, find b. So I'm going to have you do this, but just to remind you, to go through real quick, we did y2 minus 1 over x2 minus x1, and got the slope. Plugged the slope in, took this point, plugged in the x and the y. The only thing we did after that was to solve for b. For b, you know, what b was, and plug in b, so we have y equals minus plus b now. I want you to start with the slope. Okay, and if you want to keep going, we're going to find the equation as well. these numbers are going to be nicer than I can do 11/6 and 97/6. I'm going to work out one nicely for you as you work on your own. So start with finding the slope. Once you find the slope, if you're done, you can continue on, plug that slope into the point, and find the entire equation after solving for b. You're going to find the slope in someone. We've done this a few times. Can someone walk us through finding the slope real quick, Shelby?
All right, so y1 minus y2, and then x1 minus x2.
That would work.
And so what I did was, I did 3 minus 9.
3 minus 9.
And
4
minus
2. Okay, so 3 minus 9. So we come back over here to the start with this one, 4 minus 2.
And then I got negative 6.
Negative 6 over 2.
Mm-hmm. And then I plugged in my first point.
Well, we got negative 3, right? Negative 6 over 2 is negative 3.
So you just need 3. Okay.
So we know the equation looks like this to start with. Y equals m, which we just found. X plus b. And you did what?
And I plugged in my first point.
What point did you plug in?
Just
4, 3. So you plugged in 4 for x,
yeah.
3 for y.
Mm-hmm. And so you're going to do 3 times 4, right?
Right, it's negative 12.
Yep, and then you're going to divide that by 3, and that's going to be negative 4 equals b.
Don't want to divide, we just want to cancel out this negative 12 here, Ariel.
You add 12 to both sides.
Add 12 to both sides, because b, so it's like b minus 12. We add 12, we get nothing. Add 12. So we get b equals 12 plus 3, 15. So now we know m, the slope. We know b, the y-intercept. Y equals negative 3x plus 15. Again, we find the slope. The same thing we did on the previous page. The numbers just work out more nicely. We find the slope. Then we plug in the slope with a point. And by that, I mean we plug in negative 3 for the slope, and we plug in 4 for x, 3 for y, and solve for b. Then we'll have m and b. Plug in m and b, we have the equation in the line.
And
yeah.
I do one with you, so you can tell me where I'm going wrong.
So I don't think I have another one sitting here.
I guess I do. Yeah.
Just take this one for example.
Okay.
So let's do this one.
Board?
What's that?
Can I do it on the board?
Let's just work this out.
Okay.
Slope. So I'm going to help you find the slope. Jenna?
I think it's negative 6 over 5.
Negative 6 over 5. Negative
5. You're close.
Let's do, okay, I see what happened. Let's do 1. No. Let's do negative 5.
Yeah.
Minus 1. Mm-hmm. Negative 6 over what? Jenna? I think it was simplified.
I did something wrong.
Well, let's see what happens. Negative 5 minus 1, that'll give us a negative 6. So let's see. Negative 5 minus 1, we should get 10 minus what?
Negative 5.
I think that might have been it. So negative 5 minus 1 is negative 6. Negative 10 plus 5 minus a negative 5 is plus 5. So negative 6 over 15. Is that maybe what happened? You subtract 5
yeah.
instead of adding 5. And then we simplify, they both have a factor of 3, we get negative 2 over 5. And so we found our slope. So in our equation, y equals mx plus b, now we know m. M is negative 2/5. We also have an x and a y, let's say we use this as our x and y, negative 5 over 1. Equals 1, y equals m times x plus b.
You're going to have to use for some purposes.
equals negative 2/5 x plus b, which is a negative 1. So y equals negative 2/5 x minus 1. Yes, so that's the question. All right. Quiet. We'll forgo the point slope form.
Yeah.
We will probably shortly, but it would have been more shortly. Struggles in attention. Let's see what we have here. Let's go on to these last two should be super fast because it's like some of the work's already done. What if I told you that there was a point at 3, 2 and it had a slope of, let's call it 5/3.
Yeah.
So now I'm telling you a slope and the point, a point, and I'm telling you the slope. Okay. If you think about it, in the previous problems, we had to do some work at the beginning to even find the slope. I'm just telling you what the slope is. So you use your noodle there.
I get it now.
Here we go. We're trying to write this equation, y equals mx plus b. If I told you that there is a point on the line at 3, 2, and the slope is 5/3, then what can we say about this equation? Like, what things do we know about this equation?
Y equals 2,
that's x. And?
5/3
is the slope, right? Just plug it along. 2 is y, m is 5/3, x is 3, b is the only thing we don't know.
Yep.
5/3 times 3, we cross cancel the 3s, we get a 5 there. 2 equals 5 plus b. Subtract 5 from both sides, b equals negative 3. So we have found, as we said we would, with two points, we find a slope, then we plug the slope and a point into the equation, we find b, and we're done. Slope and a point, even easier. I give you the slope and a point, so you just throw them in there, solve for b, you have b. And here it is. I couldn't get any easier than telling you that the slope is 3/4, and the y-intercept is 5. What to plug in for m and what to plug in for b, essentially, slope and y-intercept. Yes. Let's take the rest of the time to work on our homework.